Tuonge na Gabriel bana. Tuonge na Gabriel.
Gabriel bada nangoja bibi yake.
Bibi yake Cynthia sijui yako wapi.
Alafu Jubilee walimroka huyu.
Imagine bwana. No.
Hata kuna kazi.
But jealous is not kazi. Fair, eh?
Very unfair.
It's Gabriel Muthuma is in the house.
Vita yenye Gabriel amepigania. Okay, by the way.
Yeah. Roho safi.
Let me talk to the president and the people at State House. Now listen, Uhuru Muigai, my guy.
I can't do that.
Uhuru Muigai, my guy.
Yes.
Listen. Kama kuna mtu anatetea chama kuliko o Gabriel hapa. Hakuna. This guy deserves a post.
Apatio kitu.
Apelekwe hata kama ni Rakbas. Akwende huko, apote huko. Lakini huyu amepigania
hata kama ni Djibouti.
Basi aenda kue huko. Hata kama ni Panama.
Atache.
Atache huko Madagascar. Uyu jamana pi. This guy is everywhere.
Gabriel Muthuma.
Preaching one voice and one voice alone.
There's no TV station he
the
has
drum
not.
That this guy hits. Yeah, you believe.
Yeah.
No, Uhuru Muigai, my guy. I repeat.
Gabriel.
Gabriel. You say both names.
Yeah. Muthuma.
Muthuma.
There you go.
Gabriel Muthuma.
Jitete, bro. Jitete.
No. This is a chance. You know the State House listen.
Crazy Monday. Crazy Monday.
You know the State House listen. State House listen.
Yes.
This is a frequency for State House.
Correct.
Yes. Wambia wache jokes.
Kazi umefanya.
Man. We've been educating people.
Yes.
Mm. Telling people the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And you know something I've come to realize, Jeff? People don't get the truth. People don't understand the truth.
People even understand what they want to understand, Gabriel.
That's the problem. That's the problem.
Selective.
It's just like the other day what I was telling you. Somebody said, you guys, you don't talk about rail. I'm like, let me tell you. No man who will go down in history as somebody who has fought for the rights that we enjoy, like Right Honorable Raila Amolo Odinga. You'll never take that away from him.
Correct.
And you see, it is funny that when you talk the truth, sometimes it's just the truth.
Yeah.
People will just put you in a category and say, uyu ni wauku, uyu ni wauku. But sometimes that's very far from the truth. You know, sometimes you just put things as they are. You guys are going to lose this thing because you don't have a strategy. You don't have a plan.
Mm.
You know, you hired a very good guy. He came here. He realized your campaign is all in tatters. He got into the next plane, Salim Lone, and left.
Took off.
Yeah, why are these people taking off? Because you don't have what you call a concrete plan of winning an election.
Even David Ndii has gone quiet.
Well, but you see, that's the other thing. But half of the time when somebody like that opens their mouth, you are left wondering, is this guy an economist? I mean, look at it, Jeff. Somebody taught us, and this is, again, this is just the truth. The economic weight of the economic weight in this country, you know, it's a premium of what we call what were the things that we sell out. You know, what we are, the visitors we are able to bring in. You know, it's the weight of the material. And then guys like Ndii will go and compare Kenya with America. In what way are we like America? We are still changing money here to take our people to hospital. America is doing intergalactic missions, trying to send somebody to Mars and the moon. How can you compare to these two countries?
Yeah.
You know, we were just talking about Hurricane Harvey.
Correct.
Guess what? America is still moving on.
That is
how big the economy
and
is.
And Houston will recover.
You've seen that. Somebody said, we still need to go out. Oh, we need riots. We need, it's our constitutional right.
Uh-huh.
Jeff, you know very well. In the U.S., they are picketing every day.
Every single day.
Every single
day. Outside the White House.
And guess what? Outside the White House. There you go. And guess what? That economy is not affected. There's a Boeing plane landing and taking off in an airport on every second.
Every second.
I mean, that's the material. All right? That's the weight of what they produce. People are driving Corvettes out here. People are driving Ford Mustangs. That just shows you. You know, we are trying to tell people, come to Kenya and invest, come to Kenya. And then guess what? What do we do? We are gallivanting across town, you know, destroying property and what have you. And then somebody comes on TV and tells you, I'm an economist. And he actually destroys the first tenet of what it means to have a sound economy.
And that is
peace.
Let's hear from your wife who's just arrived.
Oh, wife indeed. Good to see all you people after the election.
Cynthia.
Yes.
You know, Jalas and I and Gabriel,
yes,
we'll talk about how you two
have
become so synonymous with elections. And you fought the fight for your respective parties.
Yes.
Lakini asante ya punda.
Ni hivyo. Actually, niliangukia kwa chochote in Busia, actually. I'm actually a nominated MCA.
What is that?
That is a legislator back home. And I'm
nominated
proud to be
MCA.
Imagine.
That's like,
these people like threw you to Busia.
Oh, well, I'm proud to be at home, so that's
you're meaning get that.
No, that's a mimi. Can we veto?
Why not to be we part to of veto. The national now, politics?
Now, if you are talking Jalas, if we, there's anybody we need to talk to, talk to Musalia.
Let me ask you this, Gabriel, if you were offered MCA in Tharaka Nithi, would you take it?
Why wouldn't you take it?
I'd refuse it with a pound.
Why? Why would you do that?
What? I've never lived in Tharaka
Nithi.
I have no
local.
Idea.
You need to
I have no idea what guys in Tharaka Nithi need. Man, I'll turn my back like Lord's wife. Let me turn to soul.
I'll take nothing. You guys were thrown under the bus.
It's the way of politics.
This brain and everything.
Yeah. Can you imagine?
That's all right. Use it back there.
You legislate in Busia.
If you can do it at Busia, then you can probably in the future probably just make it to the national.
Cynthia belongs to the Senate. If not the Senate, Gabriel, she needs to be the ambassador.
Roho Safi, and you know, maybe you're just being kind and nice, Cynthia, but that's a slap.
In the across the face, a smack. Oh, a slap
Busia
is a good
one. MCA?
Man. I think we have the responsibility to actually shape that kind of thought or goodness. Opinion. Yes, goodness, because legislating at any level is a big responsibility because you still have the oversight responsibility, representation responsibility. Of course, now as a nominated person, then you just are a specially elected person taking care of the interests of whosoever across the county. And so I think that is a great responsibility.
So,
faithful with little, then you will be entrusted with much.
Who's your speaker in the county assembly?
Ben Wamalwa. He was the former speaker and we have re-elected him.
That's Cynthia's position.
Why? This is not a depressing state of affairs. This is exciting.
I am depressed for you.
Why would you be depressed
for me? I am depressed.
Nominated MCA Busia.
You know, in other words, Jeff, let me be honest with you. In other words, it's like that Kati girl who walks around the office. They don't want to let you go.
If you want
they want
to
see you around.
Our local legislators.
Hang on a minute.
To be subordinate staff. We are not subordinate in leadership
in
Kenya.
That's a political. It's just a political thing. You know, we want to keep you around. We, you know, hang us. You know, we don't have anything to give you. We knew we would have given you the Senate.
We'll toss you a bone.
Stay on the corner. You know, be serving tea. We'll be seeing you around.
Oh,
but, you know, that's
Cynthia.
That in no way undermines my qualifications. I know
it
who
doesn't.
I am. I know that I can do better. Okay. Here I am taking this invitation to be on air and therefore being able to contribute my little piece in national politics. So let's talk. What are we talking about?
We're getting over the shock of the nomination of an MCA.
I can't even talk.
I know.
I can't even talk.
You have no words.
Let me tell you. Just like I was... But thank God at least MCA will be
here.
Uyu ata... Ata driver. Ata driver.
I'm going to be burning things, man.
That's right.
Cynthia wanted to know what we're talking about. I saw dirty little secrets. And this is what actually Jalas was talking about. The people who find Form 34Bs on your trousers and...
So what dirty eaters is scandalous information that watchmen, hostels, and barmaids keep, which
they are
can
telling
break
you to be,
marriages.
Be friends with your watchman. Has a knowledge of information.
Yeah, it is good to get information from everywhere.
And your house girl.
Anyone around you, yes.
And your house girl, actually. Keep them close.
It's the same attitude you guys now have with MCAs, thinking that they're subordinate and less than leaders.
Okay,
Cynthia,
are you looking forward to this new gig?
Yes, I am. I really am, apparently. At first, it took me a while to get
So it caught you by surprise.
Was shocked.
Because I was already rolling here in Nairobi, and so now going back at home, you need to make some readjustments, acclimatize yourself, re-socialize yourself.
Yes,
and so
that's
something that you need. It's a transition.
So basically, now you're based there.
Yes, I am. Okay, not based. I'm based in, I'm a national base.
I know.
Nairobi, Busia.
I know, but when they're sitting, obviously you'll be there for the week and maybe Nairobi once a month or whatever it is, right?
Yeah, over the weekend.
Good Lord.
She's going. We need to sing her that song.
What's up?
Leaving on a jet plane.
Oh, please.
Don't know when I'll be back again. You'll be singing that. We'll be,
I love that song.
I know, man. We're to be singing that to Cynthia. But let me tell you something.
Yes.
There's a 24-year-old. I've got nothing against that kid. I've got nothing against that girl. Probably
the nominated what?
The nominated.
Is she
senator?
Nominated or elected?
She's nominated.
Oh,
she was
nominated.
Nominated.
That was Cynthia's paid for crying out loud, no, NASA.
Every party has a has its own slot, and I think that is good to bring the youth up.
I've got nothing against the youth.
And you are quite youthful, Cynthia.
I'm telling you.
Youth is just a number, as I suppose. So.
We are fighting for you. They can change their mind. Yeah. So keep pushing it. No, I think this woman...
We even have a much bigger fight for this guy.
From absolutely nothing. See,
Cynthia's already in Kidogo.
And he was in every station.
So,
every day.
I have a toehold.
Cynthia tayari ameingia
Kidogo.
So from where she is, she can at least... You never know.
Na Muthuma?
Muthuma from zero. We are fighting from zero. So Uhuru Muigai, my guy. Do something. This your man, my guy. This your man.
Taraka Nithi.
Mwangalia hata vile amejiva.
Niko true.
Umevaa uniform ya
State House. True to the cause of
uniform ya State House.
Wonderful red tie.
White and red.
Okay, guys. 35 days and 35 nights. We're back to this again.
Back to the game, yes.
Cynthia. We're back to this again.
Back to it. And as a politician, never say die. It's not over until it's over. Mm-hmm. And we just feel like mungu ni mungu, because we really do feel that we were cheated from our victory. And the court ruled in our favor, and we are back to it. So this time we are re-strategizing. Of course, we've got a new vibrant team. The people who've been elected, all of them, have that responsibility to everybody now come back down to zero. Mm-hmm. Come down to zero as... MCAs, whether you're a senator, a governor, an MCA, all the leadership in the political parties of the coalition, NASA, all have that responsibility to go down to your village and mobilize. We want to get out the vote. This is going to be won by getting out the vote.
Do you think you can do it this time around, Cynthia?
We can do it this time around, because already we are seeing the participation of people, even as they're giving into our fundraising program that is being criticized.
Fundraising. How much have you raised so far, Jalas?
By yesterday, it was 8 million.
8 million on the pay bill?
On the pay bill. But that was Saturday.
Saturday.
When the M-Pesa was down.
Oh, yeah.
But yesterday, it had reached 20-something.
Okay, Gabriel, who has the momentum right now? Who would you say has the momentum?
You see, last time, in fact, I think we've discussed this this before, and I was telling you, you know, don't ever play with the powers of an incumbent. And the fact that, you know, Uhuru is known to have some friends who have deep pockets, you know, it's just the momentum that he needs to push with. Now, Cynthia can, you know, has alluded to the fact that this was the election, it was stolen. I mean, we know for sure, there's no way. Personally, I don't believe you can steal 1.4 million. That is no. I mean, talk about maybe 100, 200,000, but honestly, 1.4, well, that's pushing it too far. Mm-hmm. But having said that, I think the momentum, you've already seen it. And Cynthia has said it will go back to the grassroots, getting this MCS. The problem is, Jeff, people are broke. That's just the fact.
Yeah.
Whether in Jubilee, whether in NASA, people don't have the money. And when you're going to say you're talking about the MCAs and then maybe the MPs and the governors to come out, high governors at this point, and they know how they were elected. Some actually were told, wewe, kazi yako tutakuonaga Nairobi na mkubwa, hiyo kazi wacha. And many people lost their jobs through that. You know, some governors. So governors are going to actually put their minds down into their counties. Anyang Nyong has already started. You saw what he said in Kisumu. Mm. You guys, you cannot destroy Kisumu. This is us. All right? This is me. I'm running the show.
This is my zone.
So that's what governors are going to take. And then the MCAs, honestly, at this point, people want to recoup the money that they spend during the campaigns. And guess what? They don't have that time now to start digging back into their pockets, starting to get money. Unless you have some serious money that you're getting from your presidential candidate, then actually you're roasted. So this one is going to be won, and I agree with Cynthia, is going to be won by the people who come out and the person who has resources.
So it's Cynthia, no, how do you avoid voter apathy and get that last person to show up and vote?
By staying true to the cause. This is not all about money. Yes, money is critical in an election, but it's not all about money. There is a cause. What is the cause? What are you fighting for? What do you stand for? And these are the principles that you continue to emulate. These are the principles you continue to even share on your platforms. All the leadership that has been elected in the NASA coalition should be able to share these tenets of the cause. Basically, restoring democracy by having everybody, the people's vote count, and not technology. Because when you say that you cannot win by, I mean, steal 1.5, you can steal as much, so long as technology is involved. And you know that that was a major thing in the Supreme Court hearings. And so we know that technology played a part in the theft of the vote. And therefore we want to... gave you your time to talk. Let me just say this, that technology did play a part. And this time round, we are a bit jittery and having the same team at IEBC once again oversee this election. And so it's going to be important for us to be speaking about this.
Guys,
just say exactly what the leader is saying.
Did you guys watch Deputy President William Ruto last night on Hussein Mohammed's Sunday Live?
Yes, he did.
He wasn't happy, was he?
No.
He wasn't happy, but he did say a couple of things. He said at the heart of democracy is the election. At the heart of this election is the voter. And that voter is the people. And that the sanctity of that vote. Of course, that is all true. But then, who is then counting that vote? And that's now places... the responsibility squarely on the IEBC. Now, if IEBC now bungles that election, of course, this is an independent institution, but we want then the personalities who are running that institution Gabriel, to be shifted around so that we can have people who can do this.
He was pissed.
Totally.
He was pissed. Totally.
And I would. And
you,
I would.
You could
because,
see.
You know, for the first time that he realized, man, these guys, they've actually beaten us in the legal game.
Not only legal game, everywhere.
It's the tyranny of brains that we always say. When you're talking about
technology, and you're saying the technology failed, all we needed to do, and this is what many people across so many nations have said, get the forms themselves, the physical
produce
forms.
Produce 34B.
And guess what, Jeff? This is something many people are not saying. But IEBC called this election using the physical forms. That is one thing many people are not saying. And that's why I'm telling, sometimes it's true. Truth is stranger than fiction, as people say. That's all you needed. And I don't know where the Supreme Court never saw this. But again, that is water under the bridge. We are moving on.
Sure.
So as much as you're talking about having technology, as much as you're talking about, you know, putting people, the right people, you know, having memos coming in. And you had the DP talk about the memos. And that's what I said. We need to start understanding this narrative. Who was that memo written to? Because it was not written to Chiloba. All right? If you look at it, it has a huge stamp on it, confidential. If this was a memo, a confidential memo from the chairman to Chiloba, to the CEO, it would not have seen the break of dawn.
Come on, there are ways of leaking it.
No, now that's where I'm going. Who leaked it? Because very few people would be privy to that document. It's either the commissioners.
Cynthia, should the IEBC be reconstituted?
We don't have the time. We don't have the time. If I was to say anything, I would have wanted to have this election in another 6 months. But of course, with listening to what the deputy president said yesterday, it already hurt. On the day that the judgment came out and the ruling from the Supreme Court, we lost a couple of billions of shillings.
Yeah,
and every single day, we are losing it.
Absolutely.
And so doing another 6 months, I mean, we would be...
We don't have the luxury of time.
We don't have the luxury of time. And it would have been good to have the time to maybe not reconstitute. And I think then the chairman is taking now this whole responsibility into his hand by shifting people around in the management. But of course, this has all come out in the public domain and we're all commenting on what he's doing. He's actually doing his work. If he felt that you didn't perform in this duty, why don't you move and sit on this seat? It's just like a merry-go-round in that institution to try and get people to work because they're all trained, they're all working, they all know the running of this institution. It is a secretariat that has been running elections for the past, since it was instituted, I suppose, in 2007. And so if the secretariat has been working, then we do have staff that know exactly what they're doing. If you move them around, I'm sure they would be able to deliver. But I don't want us to focus on IEBC because at the Supreme Court ruling, we saw Jubilee completely taken off guard. They were completely in shock. And right now, moving our focus from Jubilee and knocking them and continuing to hammer in places where they were not ready is a strategy that I think the Jubilee strategies are trying to move our sights from Jubilee and seeing their weaknesses and poking holes in their entire narrative in the campaign and telling us to focus on IEBC and their whole management structure and what is going on in IEBC.
When you listen to a politician, you get several divides that don't make sense. Just before we removed the ISAC-led commission, the problem was the chairman. As NASA had actually put it, it was no longer the CEO, Oswago. It was the CEO. Now, you're talking
about it.
It was Isaac Hassan. This time round, they have no problem with the chairman. Chebukati. Mm-hmm. They have the problem with the CEO. Look at how that has shifted. Those are the dynamics. I'm telling you, when you listen to a politician, you get things so mixed.
But like Cynthia said...
Like I said, staying true to the cause of fighting for electoral reforms, wherever you see the weakness, you want to make the change right there. What
are
the weaknesses?
We are the ones who say, remove this.
If the head of the entire institution was not performing,
we are
then you would want to
move
them.
We are back to where we were. And people are now wondering, hey, why did we even have...
Where did we miss it?
Let the commission leave office because they did that unconstitutionally.
As they were supposed to.
They did that unconstitutionally. Hang on a minute. They didn't. When you say they've not performed, and this is what Kenyans now want to see, you people have almost a one-on-one. It's as if you've read the judgment which was supposed to be brought out in 21 days, and people are getting concerned. So what is happening between
IBC? That's why I used the words if they did not perform, because I do not know the details.
Now,
we are not privy to those details.
You had the DP say,
we
this
know
memo,
technology
this memo,
was a major Mira, issue, hang on and a technology this, did not this, perform as planned.
This memo actually mirrors the very same questions that NASA is asking for. And you have to realize that this person called the deputy president is coming from a place of knowledge and information. So when you intensify that, people are starting to ask those questions. And let me tell you where I think we went wrong with IEBC is putting a chairman that we say the chairman must have a legal advantage. No, Jeff, you want this?
An advantage.
When you really want, and I'm telling you this truth, you want this IEBC to be run professionally by somebody who understands all the end things, you know, how finance is moving, how IT is moving, how marketing and everything, get somebody like Michael Joseph. You'll have an amazing election.
All of a sudden, Michael Joseph.
Joseph, because he's running the M-Pesa and running the money.
He did a very good platform. He ran
a safari. To run your election, you just
of course,
need a professional.
Because you're talking about technology. Chebukati has got no clue what technology
is.
Zero. And then you're saying that is where the problem was. But he's not using his team.
Okay,
he just saw the other day. He removed a memo and half of his team commissioners did not even know about the memo.
Gabriel, should Chiloba resign?
If found culpable, it's not about resigning. If found culpable, Chiloba, the man should be in prison.
Thank you very much for agreeing.
Okay. If found culpable,
my
the man should be in prison.
Well.
And if, even the chairman himself, and my problem is the chairman giving excuses. Mm-hmm. A good chairman, a former chairman in the company that I ran, used to tell me, anytime somebody is talking about an excuse is not spelled with an E, it's spelled with an F, failure. You cannot pass the buck. The number one thing, even if I was the chairman, the first thing Jeff would have done is call a crisis meeting. Where did we go wrong?
And this I think is we what have I've been seen Chebukati
it's not about
do this.
Memo.
We have seen Chebukati
no. call
do
a
this.
Crisis meeting.
He called a crisis meeting. Half the commissioners don't turn
up. They went
up.
On a retreat.
They went on a retreat. This was only this weekend, this past weekend.
That's
but
what
before,
we should have done. That's
before
what we
before
have seen.
The weekend, we already saw the cracks. We already took the commissioners themselves among in the team. Mm. They already started taking sides. Whose fault is it? Blame game. And until now, that crisis came to full-blown public domain where we started saying, are these people really strong enough to hold another election?
Cynthia,
is when now they called.
Let me ask you
retreat.
This actually, it's that same question. Will NASA accept the same IEBC to conduct the same election as they did on August the 8th?
IEBC is IEBC, it is an independent institution. Will NASA accept individuals in IEBC that have the responsibility of overseeing? So the question is on those individuals. First and foremost, we have a problem with Chiloba being the head of the secretariat running this election.
Chiloba, you have Chilo a problem with Chiloba?
Yes, that Bay needs to leave that secretariat or be moved down to, I don't know, some other subordinate position. I don't know his terms
of agreement.
They
started by calling him Chiloba. They said Chiloba and now it's Chiloba.
Baptize him whatever you want to baptize him. We will not go into this election with Chiloba as the head of the secretariat.
You will not.
We do not want to. We feel that he failed us and we don't want to risk that.
Do you remember when we were having a discussion, I told you, give a mouse a cookie, it comes for a glass of milk.
Yeah.
Do you remember that?
Yes.
That is what happened. Jubilee will not move an inch now on IBC because they've learned the hard way. That time they did a legal, they call it a political legal bypass, and allowed the Hasaki-led commission to be actually moved out of office.
Replaced.
Badly.
Once again,
and they realized, hang on a minute.
You really need
they
to know
realized,
what you're in.
Hang on a minute.
When you're
they
in the
realized,
game.
They realized we actually gave a space. Electoral reform. They took a mile. And guess what? It's not about electoral reforms. If you wanted
it electoral reforms, electoral
you undermined them in 2007.
You put an independent institution what there to run your election. What they realize, what they realize,
we have been, the ones moving.
So Cynthia,
guess what? We will not move.
Cynthia,
and that is worth.
Yes.
Do we see ourselves in another Supreme Court situation? All over again, deja vu. Do it. Can we see ourselves?
Deja vu. And how long would you want to deja vu? Get it right. Get it right from the onset when you still have the time to get it right. And this is the pressure that NASA right now is putting on the institution, because we did go onto the streets for these electoral reforms. We've put them in office. Then they need to step up. They really need to perform, and they need to really deliver an election that is free, fair, credible, verifiable. It is the verification of these numbers that you keep talking about as jubilee.
And go on.
I want the viewers to listen to me.
Listeners.
I don't believe.
You've done TV too much, you know that.
I do not believe we are going to have an election that will hit the threshold.
Yes, I'm sorry, hold on.
Everything, honestly.
It should be 75% correct.
I was with ELOG. We went for a few, and when I say into a few, it's not just like two or three or four. Went to about 30 polling stations. And can I tell you what?
In one county?
There was no all over ballot the stuffing. There was no ballot stuffing. The kids worked very well.
In some all places right? did
hang
not.
Hang on a minute. Hang on a minute. We did
I
a
was also
very
an observer.
Good. We did a very good, credible election.
So you're saying this
I
one will not
to
meet
see,
that?
What is the percentage the that
one.
Would make
this
it
the
now
best
credible.
One we've ever had? And I'll tell you, this is the best one we've ever had. And time will prove me right. You wait.
But so you're saying it wouldn't meet the threshold?
I don't think it will. This coming on, I don't think it will.
I don't think it will.
What about turnout?
Turnout. Oh, we're trying to rip up the votes.
We had 15 million, right?
Yeah,
plus minus 15
million.
15 million
probably
change.
Have 10 million. Ooh. Probably have 10 million, because of course there has been that accept and move on, and then they're tired. There's voter apathy. Definitely, there is voter apathy.
Yeah.
So to try and whip up the people to come out and vote again, they're like, I'm going on with my life. You guys, you politicians, just do your thing. Yeah. You know, whoever
and
wants
what?
To
have
lead,
people,
get
have
your people and let them
majority
vote.
Majority of
as
the
for
people
me,
in our cities.
Mm-hmm. And so
they're saying, sounds, they're saying
they won't go back. Machine
you're not going
to
go back.
But even hardly. If, guys, even if it's just you're voting in one category, it's not six. So you're not going to be in line as long.
Jeff, it doesn't matter.
It'll flow.
It
It'll
doesn't matter.
No?
You're asking somebody to spend 2,000 to go back Mashinani to just cast a vote. No, I won't.
It's
many will not go. I'm just telling you. And I agree with Cynthia on that one. You'll have serious voter
there will
apathy.
Be, there will be voter apathy. I feel that. Because even before the projections, what the surveys had already given us was 80%, 90%. And we didn't see that in reality.
Right.
So how true were those surveys in the first place that people would have started working on? Maybe this has been the truth, that we only usually get 70% of voters out. And now if we're doing this rerun, we'll probably get 60 to 50% out. So that's
shame.
Going to
and
be something that will affect
the results.
And people
will be coming out angry.
Right.
To vote.
Right.
It will be an angry vote.
Yeah.
That's what I'm calling
but
it.
I'm NASA supporters, I know, are very energized. They feel this is a window that they have just received straight from heaven, and I know they can
but
be more, in the stronghold.
But let me ask you this,
going
Cynthia.
To be coming out to
energized,
vote.
But you know, the rumblings within NASA. I mean, Hassan Omar took off like a bat out of hell from Wiper, resigned. And then Kidero looks like he could be offered a cabinet position. You never know. So.
You just never know. Those are the intrigues of politics.
Correct.
But once again, when you see that the losers are being brought together to work for Jubilee, I know like in Western Region, they've brought in together all the poll losers.
Mm-hmm.
You need to know that this was a statement from the ground.
That.
No,
you
the people reject you.
Losers.
The people have rejected
no.
you.
Guess
the people
what?
Have rejected
Jeff,
you at the back, and there is nothing
no.
you're going to
listeners,
do.
Listeners don't even take Cynthia serious.
Gabriel,
when you
before
lose
you answer,
an election,
before you
the
answer,
people
Gabriel,
have rejected
Cynthia,
you.
Before he answers, two words. Isaac Ruto.
Yeah.
Wasn't he a principal? Wasn't he a principal?
Exit stage left. And that's what I'm saying. You see,
there
don't,
are pluses
don't, look,
and
don't
minuses.
Look at people as losers, because guess what? Mm. Mostly in Western. Go to Ken Lusaka and tell him you're a loser.
And he's Speaker of the Senate.
Hello!
The Senate,
and,
yeah.
And you are, high.
And you are nominated MC?
No, because then if you don't win, how many votes
do
you bring in? You because then Jubilee is expecting you to bring that 100,000 votes that you brought initially.
Sir, it doesn't matter.
I doubt he will be able to raise that 100,000 that he did the last time. Really? Even as a Senate Speaker, really? Yes, he will have to use the 8 members of Parliament that have come through. But then, even those.
But then don't call him a loser. He's
you
a speaker
do remember
of
that the
Senate.
Maths was that NASA had about 5 candidates who each bagged in some votes. Jubilee. So if they're going to be solidifying this vote
Jubilee
against the one...
MPs
from Western,
because it was very strategic to have this one person take the win from 6 other candidates who are dividing the NASA vote, and so you'd find that that person has won. But
and
if you put those 6 six candidates' votes together, you still have a win in
Cynthia,
that constituency.
Cynthia Gabriel, let's not forget, the minute you lose, you are outside the tent.
Telling
for
you, man,
next five years. That can be cold.
For it some is. Political oblivion, completely out of politics.
That can be frigid.
And
look at somebody like Kalonzo.
To dine at State House thinking that they will deliver. I mean, when you look at people like Kombo and people like Mr. President, you know, the president, what's his name? Wefoli Bekole and whoever. I mean, these are people who've been in oblivion, bringing them back to come and mobilize for
look,
you.
Look
what
at somebody.
Results are you expecting? Really, you're out of the tent. You're out in the cold. There's nothing that can you can actually deliver. Apart from having something for you to put on your
Is it sort of like Munya going to NASA?
Yeah.
Look at what Munya is doing.
What is he doing?
In Israel. Gosh, you look at the rally. The people came out and they were listening to him. If you can get people to come out and listen to you, at least you have planted that seed that there is an alternative to this repression that we've been going through.
What impression
that
will Munya have, Gabriel?
This is what I just told
you.
What did you just see? Cynthia has already gotten a mentality of an MCA. Ah! Listen, guys from Western, no great impact. Munya, great impact. Let me tell you. It doesn't matter. When somebody leaves, it doesn't matter who they are, they'll bring them some votes. Munya still will bring in some votes to NASA. Of course,
yes.
Of course. And that's the
significant
truth. Not really, but he'll bring in some votes.
Significant, better than
because
what we got
you
the
have
last
to realize,
time.
You have to realize, the guys, I mean, that area you're talking about, those people are known to laugh at you. But
if
when Bush comes to show, man, you get a very serious surprise. Having said that, Jeff.
But he got a slap down from
Kiraito. Exactly.
He got a slap down.
Totally. But what you've just said there, about people living in the cold. I think we need a progressive, a constitution whereby these guys don't just disappear into the night.
I'd like
to have an office as a form of run by the morning, something like that. I mean, he's been out in the cold, like you said, for 5 years, and if it doesn't work on his side, another 5, he's gone. Governor Muto will have picked and left. You'll be 10 years off, you'll be toast. And now look what he's been reduced to, carrying a placard. It's like those massage things that you go on Long Gong Road and you find guys at night.
You can want to make fun about that, but that is a political
game. You cannot have somebody
why
who's
not
going to
why
vice
not?
President
if he's passionate
up,
enough
use
to hold
technology
up a
for crying out loud. No,
he didn't.
Why didn't Rayla himself hold that banner? No,
because he was speaking.
No, I felt sorry for
Cynthia. He didn't look very passionate.
I'm telling you,
he didn't look very passionate. And that's what he felt. Well, that's what he should do.
Jeff, when I say the truth,
no, people actually move by what
their
conviction. That was his conviction.
People don't like the truth.
That is his conviction. If I'm convicted enough to stand on the streets of Nairobi with a placard saying, "Hey, here I am, hire me.
I need a husband.
I need a husband. I need a job. I need whatever. I need money." And this needs to be a grassroots movement that this election is going to won by the people. We are not going to have big mega
But the difference,
companies
somebody
fundraising for us and running our campaign. We want our campaign run from the grassroots, and therefore we want 100 shillings from every person who believes in the cause.
It's not about believing in a cause.
It is the conviction that he had. He felt he should hold up this placard, and therefore, well, it's got your attention. It's got you speaking.
How
many people?
It did not
for
look
you.
Good.
It doesn't look good.
It looked like those guys alone. Have you gone by Gong Road and you found those guys advertising massages at night?
He says to be a leader, you need to serve, and he's serving in the most menial job. You should be able to do the most menial job to be a servant.
So you do admit that that is menial.
If it is just to hold up a placard, it's only your strength. Just the same way Moses raised up his hands and he needed support.
What? Moses did not carry a placard asking for money. What's happening here, Cynthia? just say the truth.
I think the nominated MCA from Busia is missing home.
Yeah. I'm not missing home. Missing I'm Nairobi. Just telling you, you're never too big to serve. You should be able to do even the any duty that you need to perform in an election campaign. If you need to hold up that placard, hold up the placard. Mm. If you need to be the person speaking to millions in Uhuru Park, be prepared with your message to deliver that message with power, with impact. Whatever job you need to do in the campaign, do it with all your heart.
Okay, guys, closing thoughts. Gabriel, starting with you.
Well, I think, like we've been told, Jeff, we are going for another election. And I think, you know, apart from our economy going into the ruins, I think we need to understand one thing. We need to move on. Like everybody's saying, we just need to move on. We cannot continue being in a in what you call an election atmosphere for years. I mean, we started last year in December. Now we are almost hitting another December, a year of nothing but crossing the country and people are talking about looking for votes. Now look at how it's become. You know, the words, you know, the verbiage, you know, it's going crazy. Boss Kuria from one end will say this. Muthama Johnson on the other end will say this. And guess what? Soon before you know, the small, solid economy that we are trying to build, Jeff, guess what? It may just be eroded with time just because we are running our noses too much on elections. And I don't know who did what and Form 34Bs. No. We need to move on. Kenya needs to move on.
I hear that. Okay, Cynthia.
I need to appeal to the 15 million voters plus that we have a rerun coming on October 17th. And yes, we will participate. What we want to put in place is the right people to actually manage this election. IEBC is our institution. This is the institution that the Constitution has given us. And we will give it all the support if we can have the people on the help give us the correct personnel to deliver a right election. Otherwise, we will be going back to the Supreme Court. Otherwise, we will be having this kind of lethargy of just being stuck in this time zone of electioneering without moving on. Everybody's speaking about moving on. It is difficult to move on when half your population feels disenfranchised. So get it right. Get it right for October 17th. I want to appeal to all the voters to come out. Do not get weary. Do not get tired. We have seen Kalonzo Musyoka holding up that placard, doing the least that he can do to deliver. You do your bit and come out and vote.
Hold the placard.
Cynthia Mutere, the nominated MCA from Busia. We wish you all the very best.
Thank you very much.
Gabriel Muthuma, the incoming ambassador to Djibouti.
There you go. Kuna mahali anaenda. I'll come to Busia.
Yeah.
I run a very successful company. Don't
wow. In Busia.
All the best to that.
No, in Nairobi.
Oh.
Okay.
So you're okay.
I'm good.
At our Kikata.
But Mr. President, please.
Mr. President, come through for this guy.
Guys, as always, what a pleasure to see you all. Cynthia, thank you for making the time.
Thank you, Jeff.
Next time you're in town,
yes,
please stop by.
Na ukitoka nyumbani pia unatubebea kitu.
Utaleta samaki.
Well done.
Kubwa.
Thank you guys. All the best. The Hot Breakfast with Jeff and Jelango.